In the previous episode, we saw how to create at least a simple user interface in Qt Designer. We created an editor with a Qt plain text edit widget in there. And the reason for doing that was not that the user would be amazed of seeing the characters fill up on the screen. It would be for him to actually be able to load and save files. And that's what we'll be focusing on in this episode, namely, how do you connect the user interface created in Qt Designer with your C++ code? That's where your business logic is living. To understand how to do the connection between UI files and C++ files, let's see what the UI file actually gets generated to. And that I already showed you last time, this here, this XML file, but that's not the end of the game. This is just the intermediate storage format for the UI file. What happens is that there's a small tool called UIC that gets executed. And the reason why it's got executed, well, let's go to our CMake file here. It's because in my CMake file, it says set CMake auto UI on, which means that it will generate a file from this UI file. And in my project sources here, I specify that it's main window.ui. So that's how the hooking or the backend is set up for this. And let's go over and have a look at not this file here, but let's go and look at the H file for my main window. My main window's H file. You can see I have a class that is subclassing from main window. It is the usual setup here, and down here as a private instance variable, it has a UI file, namely UI :: main window. So there's a class with the same name here, but inside the namespace UI. And now let's go and look at the CPP file. In here, I delete the UI and the destructor, obviously, and then I say UI pointer setup UI. So that generated code that is in UI :: main window up here is being executed with a setup UI. My UI is instantiated here. And the key thing here is setup UI is given this as a pointer. Now let's look at what this setup UI looks like. It's over here in a file called UI_mainwindow.h. And let me just hover the cursor here for a second. And you'll be able to see that this file is in home blackie. That's my home directory. Build editor desktop Qt 500 or I didn't get to do that, huh? editor_autogen/include/UI_mainwindow.h. If that doesn't scream to you, this is a file that you should not be editing, then hopefully this warning up here will. Warning, all changes made in this file will be lost when recompiling UI files. You are never ever gonna go into this file. I'm taking you in there now, so that you can understand how things are set up. So I have this class UI main window. We know that it must be a class already because we saw the forward declaration in our own header file. It has a number of different things up here, and then it has this setup UI. And if you look at the number of things, we have not as much as I would expect it, but let me just press Control B for build. And now it says here, oh, the UI file has changed on disk. Do you want to reload it? Yes, I want to reload it. It suggests that it can auto reload. I would not do that because that is the last frontier. Whenever you accidentally delete something on disk, then you at least have it in your editor. Now I see much more. I see a queue action, action save. Remember, let's go over here to our UI file that is here. I had up here, if I shrink my property editor a bit again, I have action load, I have action save, action quit, and let's go over here again. Action save, action load, action quit. So each of these, let's just go over here again. Action quit, the class is a queue action. So each of these actually get generated into this file here. And if you go down and see the setup UI, it takes a main window, and let's just remember here that it was given ourselves. So setup, the user interface, on myself, this. And what it does over here is that it sends, creates the action save. It sets the object name, it blah, 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 blah. And it creates a layout somewhere in here. Here's a central widget, the menu bar, the file, all of that stuff. And we don't really have all that much layout management in our user interface up here because the only layout we had was this widget here was in a layout on the central widget. But when we'll see layout manager shortly, we'll definitely see much more stuff here. One thing to observe is that over here they have names. Action quit. In the UI file, you'll notice up here there is action further up. Q action, action quit. And let me just go back to my user interface here. And just for the moment here, we'll just call it quit. And I'll build again. It'll say, hey, change. Do you want it to change? Reload. I'll say yes. And now you can see Q action quit. So if you know from C++ how to interact with Q actions, then now you know how to get to that widget in your user interface and to work with it. In KDAP, we offer two different kinds of training. The scheduled training, where you bring somebody to our place, and the in-company training, where we take our trainers to your company. And in those trainings, you get to choose exactly what the training should be about and what the discussion should be about. You can take a detour however long into any topic. So sign up now. Okay, with all this knowledge in place, let's try and implement save. What we need to do is to go back to our UI file. We'll notice over here that it's called action save. Now we'll go to the CPP file, and here's a magic shortcut for that. Shift F4 will jump you to the CPP file. Shift F4 will jump you back to the UI file. Very useful shortcut that we have. Over here, I've set up my user interface. I know that that is a Q action, so I can connect to Q action. I'll say connect UI, I can spell UI pointer action save, comma, and then Q action triggered. There we are. It could come to the completion for me into this, and I'm main window colon save. I'll go over here into my F4. We'll go jump between header file and CPP file. Shift F4 will jump to the UI file and back to the CPP file. So here in my header file, void save, and alt enter to the definition in the CPP file. If you just went, oh my God, that was amazing. That's a cool shortcut. Are there more? Then yes, there is. Let me just give you two links in this video here. One is for my favorite top 7 shortcuts, and that actually turned into many more shortcuts that I showed. And the other is for all the refactorings available inside of Qt Creator. Very useful things from my other show called Qt Widgets and More. Now I'm in save, and let's just debug out here just so that we know that we got something working, saving, and let's run. Now, when that requires to include Qt debug. Now when I run, my application will show up. Maybe this is the first time you actually saw the application running. Anyway, I got file, save. And as you can see here on my standard output, it now printed saving. Let's also go and actually do the saving. So for that, I need to go have the text from the text editor. Remember over here, this one here was called plain text edit. Let's just call it editor. That is what the whole thing is about. How do I get to that? Well, UI pointer editor, that was a plain text editor, and maybe I should save it over here first before too plain. It absolutely do not want to play with me. It UI editor. Well, anyway, Control K, question mark, Q plain text edit, and I'll take the 515 We'll see for that, it has methods down here. And there's one that is called to plain text, which gives me a QString. So editor to plain text. And let me just auto text equal to, and then just print that out. And well, that was a UI file again that got the generated file. So let's close that now. Here's my application running and my application file. Well, I need something in here. Hello, class, file, save. Going to my Qt creator, you can see it's saving. Hello, class. To get it into a real file, I would create an instance of a Qt file object and I would attach a Qt text stream to that, but we'll talk about that later in this class. Hey, Jesper, could you just give me a break here? There's something that's bothering me. Could you please show me the header file? And sure, I can show you the header file. I'd seen some of your other code and you have this standard for naming your instance variable m underscore. Myself, I'm using just underscore and or m without the underscore, but you just call that instance variable UI here. Shouldn't that be m underscore UI? Okay, you are nitpicking now, aren't you? You can call it m underscore UI. You can call it Jesper's UI if you want to. It doesn't really matter. Personally, I call my UIs just as it's generated here, UI, because that is such a prominent instance variable in all of my classes. They are all called UI, and I know that that particular one is for the pointer to the user interface. While my m underscore whatever object, that one, I need the m underscore in front of it just to be able to tell that it's an instance variable. But I know that UI is an instance variable. Happy now? I guess. Okay, with that aside, let me show you something that I have seen working. It was a feature of Qt Creator 11, which is what I'm using now, but it does not always work. So it's just something to be slightly aware of. Let's go over and look at our C++ code here again. Connect UI action save. And I went into save and save called UI editor to get the actual text out of that editor. And just for the fun of it, UI pointer edit plain text edit. I don't understand why it insists on that. The code model parsing must not have happened yet. But okay, let that aside. Go over here into my editor and imagine that I wanted to rename this now. So I could call it edit instead of editor. That works fine. But if I go back over to my C++ code, notice that it still goes to editor. So if I build now, it'll complain. Build now, it'll complain that editor is not known anymore. Now it's called edit. I've seen it in an announcement that it should work in in Qt Creator 11. And when you're watching this, I'm sure that we are Qt Creator 255, because this is an everlasting show. But just be aware that you might actually get in trouble there. You will definitely get in trouble. And I think that they need to go to 256, Qt Creator 256, before they'll be able to actually go and rename in here. You can Control Shift R. See, I can go up here and say, I want my main window to be called main window X. And now main window, main window X, main window X, main window X, class main window X, my main window X. And let's just get it back in here, main window. So that part works, but it definitely do not work to go here and say, okay, let's just Control Shift R. It will not even offer me anything here. So the names there, be slightly careful about them when you, before you go to the C++ file and start hooking them up, because you can see they are just called stuff like menu file action and action load. And that might be a good enough name, but maybe your naming scheme is slightly different. Maybe you want the action to just be called quit. That's it for this episode. Let's just recap real fast. So you create your user interface inside of Qt Designer. You can see the layout or the parent-child relationship structure over here. And you can, in the object name here or up here, you can change the name of the objects in here. Now, this UI file will be, because of our CMake settings, be converted into a UI underscore the name of the file .h, and that file you include in your header file or in your CPP file to be accurate down here. I include this file here. I set it up and all of that is auto-generated. So I don't really need to remember about that. That is whenever you create a new UI form class, as we'll do in the next episode, then it comes set up like this already. But what you need to remember is that now you can access that. And God knows, I have many times wanted to say, set the text of my edit. So I would say UI pointer edit pointer set plain text, I think it's called plain text. Hello. Hello class. So now it starts up like this and I run it and I'm happy because it did compile. And whenever it starts running, it says crashed. And debugging session later, well, not that much because ClangTidy actually helped me out here saying, you are aware that UI has not been initialized or UI edit hasn't been initialized yet. Oh yeah, I do that in setup UI. So maybe that line should go before. And now when I run it, you'll see that it says hello class in here. In the next episode, we'll talk about how to create layouts inside of Qt Designer. So stay tuned for that. And until then, have a great time.